want to hear my siren?
Yeah, we want to hear your siren. Wow. I'm really impressed.
Come on.
I can wait for you guys. Come on. How are we doing? Excuse me.
Can we please move back? Freddy's going to show us where the hump is.
Or extrication. My name's Bill Haskell. I'm a captain with the fire department. Working with me here today on Engine 1, I have with the red helmet, that's our officers, Lieutenant Kostrang. I got firefighter Brian Ferraro and firefighter Tim Benoit. Actually, he's Benoit. And we have our driver here, firefighter Tommy Anguilla. In the back here, that's John Halabinko. He's one of our EMTs, firefighters. He's helping out as well. So what we're going to show you here real quick is a simulation of a car accident that we come upon where the victim is trapped. They need to get extricated from the car. They can't get out on their own. So we'll respond to the scene. We have specialized equipment that will help us get into the victim. So Lieutenant Castre, if you want to start with your crew here. Again, simulating this car was in an accident, we would come on the scene. One of the four things that we have, we call stabilizing, ourself, the scene, the vehicle, and then the patient. You see all our guys are dressed in our safety equipment. Most important thing is for ourselves to be safe. We're wearing our helmets, we have our glasses on, we have our gloves, all safety equipment, so keep ourselves from getting cut or getting, you know, fluids on us. When the guys come up on the scene, make sure the scene is safe. They were showing, they were walking around, looking for any hazards, electrical hazards, flammable liquids on the ground, number of victims. Might have been times people get ejected from the car and they're not near where the car was into the accident.
All right, I got a strong voice. My wife's always
complaining
about that.
Into the patient, rotations, looking for the number of victims. What we do, we try to get, we want to get access inside the car as soon as possible. What we would do at this point, we'd send a firefighter in there with their full protection of clothes on and make contact with the patient. See what their injuries are, assess them, get some oxygen on them, and basically speak to them, assess their injuries, and put them at ease if they're conscious and able to talk to you, to tell them what we're doing. They've just been in a crash, they're obviously upset, and then all of a sudden we come around and start banging windows and taking out equipment, so it could be frightening to them. We also would go in there and hold C-spine precautions, stabilize the victim's neck. Right. Obviously, when we get in, we have a special cover we would put over the patient so that no glass would go on. Usually, this car here, obviously, it's an older car. It doesn't even have a battery in it, but what we would do, we would roll the windows down to about an inch from the top, and then we would break them. All the broken glass would then fall, would be broken inside the door to minimize any cut hazards. So they're going to use our Homacho equipment. This is engine one. We're located over here by the train station on between Munsell and Stimson on Wood Ave. We have a full set of rescue extrication equipment as well. It's engine three, which is on Elizabeth Ave on the corner of Elizabeth and Chandler. So we have two sets of rescue equipment that we could use to perform our extrication. We have a lot of coverage in regards to high traffic areas in the city of Linden. Route 1 and 9, as everybody knows here, is a very busy highway, a lot of truck traffic, a lot of cars. Many times we have many accidents on here where we have to use this equipment to get people out, as well as the, maybe you're not aware, but the New Jersey Turnpike. We cover the turnpike. Many times we respond out there with our equipment for extrication. So what they're gonna do here, they're going to pop the passenger side door here. They're going to attacking it from the lock side. Usually what we do is they're there, they pinch it, they get a little pivot point of They'll be working on the door here to get the door open so we can get access to the patient. Meanwhile, we would have EMS responding. We put them in a staging area, the EMTs or the medics. Once we get the scene saved, we get access to them, then they can go in and do some further medical treatment. We're holding their neck right now. We call it C-spine precautions. We're going to get a collar on them. And then we're going to maneuver them out onto a longboard to ensure that we don't further injure them in their spine. We have to always think that their neck or your spine is injured. Firefighter Halabinko, can you grab the net there for the airbags and steering wheel right there? Bring that over here, John. Fire. Hey, bro, get that bag right there. The net. One of the things we do is when once we get access to the car, just hold it up, John. Just a, basically a net that we would put over the steering wheel if the airbag hasn't deployed. Put that over the steering wheel, we lock it in. So for some reason, while we're doing our extrication, the airbag doesn't deploy. So if you're in front of an airbag and you get hit with it, you get injured. A lot of times what happens here, and they're struggling a little bit, is that the shell of the car, what's happening is they're spreading it, and they're not actually, you gotta get in there a little deeper and get to where the lock mechanism is and be able to spread that from the lock. What's happening is the shell of the car is separating from the door itself. But it's not this tricky, it's a little time consuming. One technique doesn't work, we have others. So this is kind of good. They're struggling here a little bit. So we're going to change our technique. So then again, we have total access. What they're going to do next now is they're going to cut the roof off. They're going to do the, cut the A post. One B's already done, they'll cut the other B post. And then we'll do what we call a fold. They'll fold the roof back towards the trunk. Gain total access to the patient. A lot of times, we need to be able to get them out vertically through the longboard, drag them out. So a lot of times, it's better to get the roof off just to get access to the patient. Thank you. they removed the windshield. They removed the windshield. Now they're gonna cut the post here to fold the roof back. On the other side, firefighter Ferraro's popping the doors with the spreader. And soon we'll have total access to the car. So again, they're getting ready here to remove the roof. By now, again, we'd have access to the patients by now. We'd have them on oxygen, assessing their injuries, and obviously we'd have enough room with the post removed on this side. If we needed to get them out on a longboard, they would already been off out into the ambulance and on their way to the hospital. One of the things when we're cutting the post like this, with newer cars, we have to be sure. A lot of cars now have side airbags, window airbags, and these airbags are deployed. They have a cylinder. We're gonna ensure that we're not cutting into this cylinder. So we go inside, we'll peel back all the plastic to see where all any type of special wiring, any, you know, airbag deployment mechanisms that we don't cut while we're cutting it with the jaws, because that'll explode and obviously cause further injury to us and the patient. A lot of hybrid cars out there now, electric. We have to be ensure that we turn off the power to the car, that we're not cutting through the wires. So at this point, they got three of them cut. Well, actually, five. 2A, 2B, 1C. And firefighter Benoit is one cut away from getting his roof off. And we'll be that much closer to drawing the raffle, winning some bikes. The most exciting part of the night. All right, so there's the roof off. A little round of applause for our Linden's bravest. A little extrication. This was about 30 minutes or so. Tough car. These old cars, they make it tough, so it's a little.
So, like you said, yes.
Right. Well, we have to peel this plastic off, ensure that we're not going to cut into anything.
And
cut around it. If we can't cut through it, it's a hazard, then we'll have to move on to another way to get the.
Tonight, we hold this annually every year, and well, I'm sure there's some people here for the concert. There are a lot of people here, especially children who are looking to get these bicycles. I'd like to thank, I've seen the mayor tonight, council president. I think we had Councilman Kozio Sadowski here tonight also, so I'd like to thank them for attending tonight, along with Councilwoman Michelle Yamakaitis. Also, I'd like to thank, we've had many sponsors tonight, Applebee's, Chevy's, Home Depot, Southern Smokehouse, the AMC Theaters. And we also had from, let me read this, Jeanette, from American Income Life. Our giveaways tonight are going to consist of a lot of things tonight. We're going to first begin with her, and then I'm going to introduce some people from the New Star Company. The New Star Company was our co-sponsors tonight. They donated over $5,000 to make this event tonight, so I'd like to give a round of applause for them. Okay, so first, I'm going to begin with Jeanette. Jeanette, you want to come out? Jeanette, you have Dunkin' Donuts. We love coffee around here, so go ahead.
We're going to raffle off two gift cards for Dunkin' Donuts right down the street.
Chris Christian. We have another winner. Christian, you go over and pick your mic. Okay, back to the girls. Back to the girls. I'm sorry. Nope, we're back to the girls. Red ticket. 786746. Somewhere. There comes the young lady. Come on up, honey. Moms, dads, aunts, uncles of the winners. We're just going to take one picture with them by the fire engine after this. So if you want, you can just come out and follow them. What's your name, Jimmy? What's the ticket? Giovanna, that's her name. Congratulations. Thank you. Okay, second bite for the boys. Blue ticket, 706108. We have a winner. We have a winner.
Hey, wait, there's
Tyler. Is this young man's name Tyler?
Hi,
Tyler. How are you today? Tyler's a winner. Go get your bike, Tyler. Going to take them over and get their pictures, so moms, dads, who's ever with these kids, please come over and let their pictures get taken. Now, if your bicycles are not your size or you want to change them, you just need to take them back to Walmart and exchange them. Okay, we're going to now mix up the rest of the tickets. We have some movie passes and things we're going to give away also, so just give us one more minute to do that. Yeah, whatever children want to buy the bikes, please meet them by the fire engine right behind the promenade over here in the parking lot. Okay, first thing we're going to give out now is two passes to the AMC Theater with a $10 gift certificate for the Smokehouse, Southern Smokehouse, and also for Chevy's. Two $10 gift certificates. It's from a red ticket. And the number is 786742. 786742. Nobody out there? One more time. 786742. Going once, going twice. Pick another ticket. Blue ticket this time, 7026122. 7026122. We'll keep going. Oh, it's somebody.
Right here.
Come on down. I'll pull the next ticket while that runner's coming down. A red ticket, 786752. 786752. Dawson was the winner of that one.
I got one of those.
Okay, this ticket here is 786752.
You know what I got
too? Going once, going twice. We'll try another ticket. Red ticket again, 786736. Rent ticket, 786736. We have a winner. Okay, two more movie passes and $10 for the Southern Smokehouse and $10 for Chef's. Next ticket. Blue ticket, 7026113. 7026113.
Right there.
We have a winner coming down the stairs.
So.
Okay, two more movie passes and two more gift certificates. Okay, the last one we have, two more movie passes with $10 for Chevy, Applebee's, and Southern Smokehouse. Again, we'd like to thank all our sponsors. We ask that you please support them. 7026100 on a blue ticket. 7026100 on a blue ticket. Anybody who owns a maroon Grand Am H86ANA,
Trans Am.
Yes, thank you. Go back to your car, please. Maroon Grand Am.
Oh, sorry.
License plate number H86ANA.
Trans Am.
Okay, last time on this blue ticket, 7026100.
That's me too.
Are you working?
No problem, okay? Another blue ticket. 7026102. Here, we got a winner. We got a winner. All right, again, we'd like to thank you all for coming out to our fire prevention night. Gary, I guess your next is your concert coming up. So thank you again and enjoy.
Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's give a big Linden welcome to Moonlight Mile.
Hello, everybody. All right, we're gonna have some fun here. I may be a little loud on the monitor. Chili, one, two, three, hey, hey, hey. All right. Much better, thank you.
Midget in the mic.
All right.
How's everybody doing out there? We're gonna rock and roll tonight. Yeah! We'll be right back.
Linden, New Jersey. Thank you very much, folks. All right. This next song is an early one. Even earlier than that one. It's called Heart of Stone. And I forgot my tambourine, mama. What's different about her?
very much, folks. We're happy to play here tonight. I had my 5-hour shot, so I'm hopefully not gonna fall on stage. I hear the nasally, man. Must be the sinuses tonight. I don't know. We're gonna do something by the Rolling Stones, obviously. Pretty much. And we're gonna wait till Wayne tunes up. You ready, Mr. Wayne? I think Mr. Wayne is ready. This is Wayne on the piano here. He Did you hear me? This is Wayne on piano here. He's doing it tonight. Wayne puts on the shows here at Linden. You may not know that, but he's one of the sound guys. An in-joke to myself. But we want you to sing along with this one as well, because we think you know it.
Coming, colors in here.
Thank you, folks. It's really sweet. It's nice, man. You know, obviously we're not the Rolling Stones, but it's really sweet to be playing their songs and to have you accept us for what we're doing. Didn't we just do Ruby Tuesday? Okay. You're a little late on the party, man.
Midnight wrap.
Take my pants off. Don't tell me. I bought boxer briefs instead of just, you know, regular briefs. I'm sorry, I was in my own. Bands in the 70s, they all did a disco song. Grateful Dead, you name it, Kiss, Rolling Stones. I'm sure we're gonna do that disco song.
I don't know the words, so maybe you can help me sing.
Thank you.
come. All right, we got to bring it down just so we can catch our breath. This is a big top 10 hit for them too. Ready? We get some couples on the dance floor, maybe?
I love this song, it's my favorite song to sing.
With no loving in our souls and no money.
very much, folks. It's a beautiful song. I hope we did it justice. I hope you're having a good time. I don't see too many people leaving after that country reference. So you must be having a good time. I do apologize for that, but I'm used to having a couple of shots while I drink. But I'm smiling, it's good for me. Hope it's good for you. I hope it's good for you, folks. Okay, how does this go? All right. Here on guitar, on bass,
piano, on bongos, on harp, on maracas. He does it all. I actually saw him play drums and bass at the same time. I don't lie. My name is Keith, and we're having a good time. I hope you're having a good time. Hey!
moon, she was hot. Well, honey, where were you? She was hot. You were in my shoes. She was hot. You'd be excused. She was hot. She could never wait. She was hot. Never hesitate. On cold and rainy days. Think I'm going off the rail. Driving down the pleasure trail. Always take a transient way. Yeah. So honey, when you're young and fresh, you need a touch of flesh. She was hot in the melted snow. She was hot in the molten glow. She was hot. She had it in the blood. She was hot like a damn mad blood. She was hot. She was strong and true. She was hot in her eyes of blue. She was hot and she took her chance. On free romance. She was hot. But it's too tall, man, bro. It's too real, man, slow. I wish you all the best. And I hope we meet again. On a cold and rainy day. Hey, 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 hey.
Oh yeah, yeah. ship. And I don't pay that California trip. I'm gonna get your kicks on Route 66. Don't get your kicks on Route 66. Yeah, don't get your kicks on Route 66.
Yeah, who needs workout world, huh? Just call me Mick Jogger. Hey, where was that hump coming from? Hey, what time it is?
Minor.
Here's going back to that, 1964 on this one? Hey, it changed all my setting.
1964.
I was born. Hey, here's an old one. This one's only about 48 years old, I think. Midnight
Rambler.
Somebody yelled,
it's all request night, I guess. You gotta stop by 11, right?
I hear it in my right ear. It's called Brown Sugar.
At the Linwood Inn, we're going to be doing the yearly Halloween show on the 25th, I think it is, the Saturday before 26th of October. Come on, prizes for the best costume.
Come on down.
Ask for the Cookie Monster.
That's right.
That's right. We got a couple more requests. We're gonna do that one too.
All right.
Hey, what a drag it is getting cold.
It's all different today. I hear every mother say.
Sweet. Yeah, we're going.
We played a million Rolling Stones songs tonight for you. Hope you liked them. But you know, the stars are moving and we gotta get going. We are Moonlight Mile. You can check us out on Facebook. But it's called Moonlight Mile. Don't ask me why. That person's no longer around. Ladies and gentlemen. Even though we did about, what, 27 Rolling Stones songs, this last song is probably going to be in your head all night. And it's not a Rolling Stones song.
But they do.
But they do do it. And we hope you like it. It's a sweet song. And you know it. You can sing if you want.
Once upon a time, you dressed so fine, threw the bones of dime in your prime. Didn't you? People call, say, beware, doll, you're bound to fall. You thought they were wrong. But can you?
Without a home, show my age, baby.
complete unknown,
but I look good.
Like a rolling stone.
That's right.
If you're not coming this Friday night to our dance night, then we'll see you all in June of 2014. Thanks for a great season, folks. Bye-bye.